Hi, everybody. Welcome to the new Q&A with Jay. This is the December edition, and this will be the last one of this year. Welcome, Jay.
Welcome. It makes you a little sad.
I know. It's been a really fast year, it feels like.
Yep.
It's flown by. And we've gotten great feedback. I want to tell you, I talked to a couple of our staff members a couple of weeks ago, and they were saying how much they enjoy these Q&As. And I said, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate that. But they said it's just important to have the same information. We're all on the same page. We all know what's going on. And I said, well, you have no idea what it's like to work with Jay.
And that can mean a lot of things.
He's a real pill.
Yeah.
But anyway, it's great to have a sit down talk with you and just kind of go through some of the things that are happening.
Yeah.
So here we are for the December edition. So let's start with the commencement that just happened, December graduates. So just give me an overview of
sure.
how that went. We had a great speaker, Joseph Kopser, who's been great.
Yeah, it was always a fun day. It's a little weird in December because there's commencement on Saturday and then we still have final exams coming.
Right.
So
timing's
a little awkward, but it was a great day, great event. Our keynote commencement speaker was Joseph Kopser, as you said, and he was awesome as we expected. He's just a bundle of energy.
Yes,
and,
he is.
And you know, as we were saying, force of nature.
Yes.
Now he had some really good points. He talked about to students about you are what you see, or it's important as a role model to realize we're all role models because people are modeling what they see around them.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I thought was a great takeaway. The other one I liked as a Gen X person. Is he told them to go out and watch a bunch of 80s movies.
Oh gosh,
and
right.
He said, you're gonna understand people you're working with, old people like me.
Speak for yourself.
They should go watch the 80s and then maybe work back to the 70s.
Yeah.
But I was thinking about all the John Hughes movies I love.
Yes.
And they should go watch, you know, 16 Candles and Breakfast Club and all
yes.
those things. But anyway,
there was so much life
great.
That happened in those movies, right? It taught us so much in the 80s.
Yeah. So he was wonderful. And then the students, you know, the students always amaze me. And Ida Hishma was the mm-hmm. student speaker, and she was great. She framed it around how she went through extracting her wisdom teeth and woke up in kind of a delirious state from the from the anesthetic, and told her mom sort of through tears she really wanted to go to UT.
Oh my gosh.
And how
wow.
that procedure made her reflect on what was really important and kind of just wove her story through that. And, you know, I joked at the end that we should have all of our admitted students also get their wisdom teeth out.
Right. It's amazing what drugs can do for you.
Maybe we'll edit that part out. No, it was great. So she did a really nice job. And it, as I mentioned, it's just a fun day.
Yes. Yeah, that's awesome. Well, congratulations to those graduates. Now let's talk about some new hires. So more people in to help train these next leaders of the world. And we're making some great strides from a management standpoint, a leadership standpoint, and also diversity standpoint as well. So let's talk about that.
Yeah, two great hires so far. A lot of searches underway. So there might be more by the time, you know, people will watch this. Some of the first departments to move on the rookie market have been the management and marketing department. Two early wins, great young talent. So in marketing, Alan Lamar is coming from Columbia University, mm-hmm. does this really interesting work looking at things like text analysis. So for example, the text in loan applications can help predict later default.
Huh.
And so what's conveyed in sort of the text on those things can predict things above and beyond FICO scores, income levels, that kind of stuff. So really, I think interesting work that I think a lot of our departments will be interested in, relevant work for today's world.
Yeah.
So he was one. And then in management, Bucky Akinsomni is come and is going to join us. She's coming from Wisconsin, and she's got this interesting work on what produces future entrepreneurs. And so looking at whether if people have voluntarily leave a position or involuntarily leave a position, whether that spurs later entrepreneurial activity from those people.
Interesting.
And if I remember right, I think her result is that kind of surprisingly in the literature hadn't thought about involuntary separations where people get laid off or restructured or fired, that actually leads to quite a bit of entrepreneurial activity later from those people.
That's so great.
So two great hires so far, more work to be done. They both bring diverse backgrounds to us and look to be just really promising scholars.
Well,
so
that's great.
Really exciting.
Yeah, well, welcome to McCombs when you get here. That's fantastic. All right, so let's now talk about the Recasting the MBA Investment Fund. We're about to approach the 25-year mark.
That's right, 25 years later. And, you know, when that was started I guess he was chair of the department, later Dean George Gao, Keith Brown, some great people that have worked on that over the years, Sandy Leeds and now Clement Siom. But the fund was unique in the sense that it had this model that it was external investors' capital. It was not the school's capital. This fund was investing on behalf of external investors. 25 years later, some of those investors are looking to get their money back to plan for their future generations.
Sure.
It's also become more and more expensive to run the fund that way, and it's not very flexible. So it's hard to adapt to market trends because it's their capital, not our capital. So we're in a process now of pivoting the fund, which we think will set it up for decades to come, into a model that will be UT or McCombs Capital. So we're going to hopefully, as we work through this, have donations come in that the students will manage. And so they'll be managing, still millions of dollars, but it'll be our capital. And so that will let us adapt, do some things creatively. It also means that the proceeds that we earn through that fund can be used for our students themselves, not like salaries, but scholarships or treks or data, opportunities that the fund can be used to enhance the student experience. And the returns now will be able to be used in that way. So,
that's awesome.
So I'm excited about the future. It's going to be a year or two of as we sort of pivot and make that adjustment. But the future is really bright there.
How do you think the students have benefited from having that fund and also being able to have the hands-on experience of managing that money?
Yeah, it's great. The buzzword today that we all talk about is experiential learning. And we were sort of experiential before experiential was cool.
Yeah.
And we were one of the first funds in the country, and it was really distinctive at that time. Now lots of schools have sort of followed that and have funds, but I don't think there's much that can replicate the experience from a student standpoint of investing real dollars, having to feel the impact of those decisions. And then we do, I think, a great job, and I think we can do even better, of getting our alumni engaged in that process.
Yes.
So we've got fantastic alums in that space. And so the more and more we can do to get them involved with the students, have the students benefit from all the knowledge and perspective they have, I think is going to make it just that much greater.
That's awesome. Now let's talk about, we're coming up on another 20-year mark with the McCombs naming gift, which happened, of course, 20 years ago. So, that celebration is coming up next year.
Yeah, it's going to be great in the spring. So the official gift and naming, I think, was late April, early May, 20 years ago, a little over 20 years ago today. And so we'll have some fun things leading up to that. So we're talking about maybe in social media, for example, something new, a story each day for 20 days.
Yes.
We're looking at bringing the family, the McCombs and Shields family, to the advisory council meeting. That will probably kick it off in late April, building up into sort of a crescendo at graduation or commencement in the spring, where we'll have a video and some other ways. But it'll be a fun time to reflect. And I mean, clearly that gift has made a huge impact on the school, on our students, on our faculty, our staff, all of us, our alumni. Yeah. So it's a great time to reflect. And I was talking to Marcia and Joe Shields, so Red's daughter and grandson, about this. And it was really nice to hear their perspective. For their standpoint, they love celebrating the past, but they really want to focus on what this means for the future and make it a story not only about the gift, but that can inspire others, but also really about how the bright the future is, where we're heading as a school and as an institution. So it'll be a great time to tell both sides of that story.
Yeah, and for those who don't know or weren't here at that time, remind us how much that gift was.
Yeah, it was a $50 million gift. And the threads that has produced are very, very vast, because a lot of it was matching money. It was used to seed certain things. So its impact, I mean, it's really hard to overstate the impact it's had.
Absolutely.
And really, I think to some extent, sets the standard across campus as well. For future naming gifts of other colleges. So it's shown the impact that philanthropy can have on a world-class school.
Yeah.
So it's going to be fun in all those dimensions, and a great way to honor Red and the impact his family's made, and also set up the stage and tell the story of where we're heading.
Yes, absolutely. So speaking of where we're heading, giving has been inspired and continues to be inspired here at McCombs, so we have some other naming gifts. We're not going to say quite yet, but talk around it if you can to get people started excited about it.
No, you think about, it's that time of year where all of us are thinking as the winter break approaches and the holidays, what's the next year going to look like, the next calendar year? And a couple of great things will happen. We will have a big naming gift to celebrate around the facilities project. We talked at one of these recently about the idea that the undergraduate teaching center would be part of the expanded project now. And we'll have a naming there to celebrate this spring that will be a huge impact on our students, whether that's a rebuilt or tear down brand new UTC. Whatever that looks like, it will be a world-class facility. And so we'll be able to celebrate that. And then one of our centers will be named as well that we'll celebrate in the spring. So should be a fun between the McCombs gift, a couple of great philanthropic impacts that will benefit all of us and especially our students. Yeah. It'll be a fun spring.
We have a lot going on, and it's exciting to end the year on such a high note and then know that beginning of next year and throughout the spring and summer, there'll be lots of great things going on here at McCombs. We also are making a great impact to South by Southwest this coming year as well.
That's right. You know, mark your calendars now.
Yes.
I think Emily Reagan, your team, working with campus, I think made great strides last year in our presence, UT's presence as a whole. This year, I think you were going to take it up one more notch.
Yes,
and so it's going to be that much more fun to see how we show up as a university at that event. It has such a great brand name with Austin, and people just know about it. So it's a place that we should be present.
Absolutely.
And show the flag, so to speak. So look for that this coming spring as well.
Yeah, we'll have a big pitch competition, and then several of our professors and faculty members will be panelists. One I know, Marissa Epstein. So if there's others that you know about, please let me know, because we're compiling a list right now of all of our South By participants. So it's great to have such a huge presence there.
Right.
Yes.
Right. I agree.
Yeah. Well, like I said, this is our last Q&A with Jay for the year. So would you like to say anything to all of our good friends out there?
I would say thanks for a great 2019. I think, you know, we're blessed to be here. I feel very fortunate to work with all of you. And today is the holiday party. This will come out afterwards. I hope all that goes smoothly and everybody enjoys themselves and shows up. That's why I'm wearing my festive orange jacket. But it's going to be great, I think, to kick off the end of a great year and look into the next year ahead. So really thanks. And I hope many of our faculty and staff and students work so hard. I hope this is a chance to pause, relax a little bit, enjoy family and friends.
Yes.
And we'll look forward to seeing everybody in 2020.
Absolutely. Happy holidays, everybody. We'll see you next year. Thank you so much for joining us today on our Q&A with Jay. We'll see you next time.